You haven't heard the last of Maybell Dorothy Wheeler. Well, to be honest, lady, I haven't even heard of you to begin with. I do see that you fancy a cheeky expedition now and then, and I do admire your spirit of discovery. But seriously, who the heck are ya? Well, at least we do know that she loves flying just as much as adventuring. Although, she must be better at one over the other. Because, as far as we do know, she came crashing down within the Hamlet not long ago. That would also mean that Wheeler was already here within the Constant. And that begs some questions. Perhaps the crash was no accident. And maybe Wheeler is here for a different purpose than our other survivors. In any case, she sits at 150 hunger, 200 sanity, but only 100 health total, making her one of the weakest survivors across all of Don't Starve. Our girl may be quite feeble, but oh boy, is she quick on her feet. At its base, Wheeler's overall movement speed is 5% more of that of every additional character. You're not on meth, but it is going to be noticeable. Heck, I even started the cliff in the bottom right here before the other one just to show you how much faster you are with less in your inventory. And yes, this boost does respond to things in your inventory. If you fill them up, you're gonna begin to notice the decrease as I said. But make note that backpacks do not count towards this negative effect. So you can keep most of your items, at least as much as you can, in one so you can keep on moving them feet quick. Speaking of inventory slots, does something seem a little off right here? Are we not supposed to have 15 slots total instead of 12? Well, if it were any other character, we sure would. But our light-footed explorer prefers to also travel light herself. But we will soon discuss how this isn't really all that limiting, to be honest. And that's because her two exclusive items, the Pneumatic Horn and the Navigadget, both have an additional slot. So in the end, Wheeler really only suffers from one less slot overall at the end of the day. However, you'll still be managing what you do and do not pick up, no matter what you gather. But these new toys, what are they and what can they do for us? Wheeler's trusty dusty, handy dandy Pneumatic Horn is a ranged weapon whose ammo is, well, almost anything, actually. You want to fire nightmares at your nightmares? Go for it, friend, and enjoy 60 damage a pew, although you really should not be firing such valuable items. So perhaps you can go pick some petals or burn some trees for the ash, and then dish out a respectable 34 damage per shot instead. At the end of the day, it is entirely your choice, because with almost no limit to what can be fired, no durability whatsoever, and considerable damage to take into account, the Pneumatic Horn is actually pretty darn amazing. But again, it all comes down to the ammo that you choose, and choose wisely. The Navigadget is next, and it can hold any item as the player can, and will proceed to guide you towards the nearest source of whatever item happens to be slotted, including lost relics. It is very self-explanatory, but it is highly useful, and can be utilized as an extra equipment slot when needed anyways. However, I will mention that the Navigadget will serve quite well in shipwreck, as placing flint or gold within one early enough can really make initial gathering and base preparation miles easier in this DLC. That, or slot a message in a bottle to locate more messages in more bottles for insanely simple and efficient treasure hunting without having to worry about passing by messages in a bottle all the dang time. And finally, as if the potential for her range combat wasn't enough, Wheeler boasts the ability to dodge every 1.5 seconds. Doing this, she'll quickly move a short distance in that time, and this can be utilized for a slightly faster navigation, but I wouldn't recommend it. Better yet, you need to use it to further combat prowess. Cause like Wartok Soulhop, Wheeler's dodge ability grants invincibility frames, meaning she will take no damage during the move. You will certainly need to learn the timings as it's a short, short window. And be smart in how you aim your dodge. My advice? Be ballsy and be rewarded. Do so, and you're not only gonna be a good pewer, but a fantastic skewer as well. Oh, and unless I am completely blind and horribly unaware, I don't think there's a way to craft additional pneumatics or navigadgets. So if you do drop them and lose them, I unfortunately think you're out of luck there, friend, so be careful, as they don't even have map icons either. Yikes. But there you have it, everyone. Wheeler, the intrepid explorer. Again, the character is not really gonna reinvent the formula of survival and Don't Starve, but her exclusive toys, their potential uses, and her movement mechanics combined make for a unique take on things, and honestly, that's kinda all that matters. The world truly is hers to explore, everyone, and you can go along for the ride. Thanks for watching, folks. Well wishes to all, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.